Secrets. I would call it secrets because many people don't know about it, nothing. Definition of acute heart failure, we all know the basic information for heart failure. Classification. There are so many classification like simplified, it's de novo or chronic, like acute chronic. De novo, it's a patient not have heart failure symptom before. CLEP class, it's specially designed for people with heart failure with STEMI patient. Class 1, no RALS, it's crepitation, you know. Class 2, RALS, SS3, elevated GVB, jugular venous pressure. Class 3, pulmonary edema. Class 4, cardiogenic shock. ECC has a different classification, you know, ABCDEFG from A to G. A, on top of chronic, acute on top of chronic. B, hypertensive acute heart failure. C, acute pulmonary edema. D, cardiogenic shock. E, war, high cardiac output heart failure. F, acute right heart failure. E, G, acute coronary syndrome. You know, E, warm, high cardiac output, like it's functional heart failure. Stevenson, it's another classification, acute on top of chronic. It's designed mainly to describe heart failure in chronic patient, acute heart failure in chronic patient, acute on top of chronic. It's a differentiate patient, warm, dry, warm, wet, cold, dry, cold, wet. What's mean by this? Warm, it's mean patient has good perfusion, cardiac index more than 2.2 liter per minute per square meter. Cardiac index, it's cardiac what indexed for body surface area. Body surface area, it's a height multiplied by weight divided by 3,600, then you can get the square root for this. Pulmonary capillary pressure less than 18, it's dry. Like it's a patient congested, if more than 18, it's wet. It's E, B, L, C. A, B, L, C. A, B, C, D. No, it's A, B, L, C. Stevenson, it's called like this. Pathophysiology, substrate, underlying cardiac condition, trigger, like infection, anemia, amplifying factor. Amplifying factor could be myocardial or renal factor, saltwater retention, vasoconstriction, neurohormonal, renal, angiotensin aldosterone system activation. Management goals to relieve symptom, decrease decrease cardiac output or DSAT. Intermediate wards, stabilize patient, uptitrate anti-failure measures or device therapy, ABC follow-up. Assessment, history, examination, investigation like we know for every patient. I would speak about little information for natriuretic peptides. Types: A, atrial, work on A receptor. B, ventricular, work in A receptor 2. C, endothelium, work in B receptor for clearance, for its clearance, like for metabolism when it's finished its work. D, from snake, urodilantin, I think it's from urinary tract. Uses diagnostic, prognostic, monitoring, screen. Diagnostic BNP less than 100 or NT-proBNP less than 300 picogram per milli. It's for exclusion heart failure. Diagnostic if this BNP level less than 100, it's exclude can exclude heart failure. Prognostic every 100 rise, it's 100 rise in level BNP, it's a 35% mortality rise. Red hot trial. Monitoring STARS BNP trial said that BNP less than 100 less hospital mortality. Screening high BNP, high heart failure risk. So, two diagnostic, prognostic, monitoring, screening. STOP heart failure trial said high BNP, high heart failure risk. Screening. Isomer for natriuretic peptide used for treatment nisritide. It's BNP isomer. Olaritide. U, olaritide, A, and B isomer, chimeric, C, ANB and DNB, Candoxa and Omipatrilate, endopeptidase inhibitor. It's like neprilysin inhibitor, old forms and not used due to severe angioedema. Page number 3, proBNP cleaved into BNP and N-terminal proBNP. So father, it's proBNP, daughter BNP and NT proBNP. BNP cleared by C-peptide, NT proBNP cleared by kidney. So neprilysin inhibitor, angiotensin receptor neprilysin inhibitor, we cannot use BNP for following effectiveness of neprilysin inhibitor, because normally it's an inhibit degradation of BNP and BNP will be increased, but we would follow a heart failure improvement symptom with neprilysin inhibitor by NT-proBNP. Management oxygen, no response sebab or can't be invasive. Class 1 C if SA2 less than 90% or BA2 less than 60 mm mercury. Oxygen. Opiate, class 2A, it's very important. Has many mechanisms for heart failure like venodilator, decrease respiratory distress, inhibit sympathetic tone, inhibit respiratory center, decrease tachypnea. Inotropes, if patient hypertensive less than 85, if patient has blood pressure more than 110, nitroglycerin indicated, not for decreased blood pressure, but venodilator, decreased cardiac preload. Ultrafiltration can be a choice. Diuretic, class 1B. If patient on chronic diuretic use, he comes with presentation acute heart failure, you need to start dose double diuretic dose with chronic therapy. Vasodilator, nitrate 10 to 200 mic per minute, class 2A, nitroprusside, nizritide, nitroprusside dose 0.3 to 5 mic per kilo per minute, class 2B, nitrate 2A, nitroprusside 2B, nizritide inotropes, non-vasodilating dopamine, 5 to 10 mic per kilogram per minute, dobutamine, inodilator, Merinone 2B. If beta blockers 2B cause of hypoperfusion, it's the best. The best choice, Merinone. Phosphodiesterase 3- inhibitor, 3- phosphodiesterase inhibitor, decrease cyclic MEB degradation. So it would increase cyclic MEB. And has a boost of anotropic effect. Non-beta receptor mediated increase in cyclic AMB, non-beta receptor mediated increase in cyclic AMB. Levosimendan 2B, beta blocker, start low with uptitration every 2-4 weeks. Beta blocker better hold it, some said it's to has benefit, later benefit in acute heart failure with very small dose. Carvid 3.125 BID, metoprolol 12.5. Bisoprolol 1.25, it's a very small dose from beta blocker starting dose. Vasopressor, norepinephrine, epinephrine. If persistent systolic pressure less than 85 on positive inotropes, you can add levo, norepinephrine. Some people would suggest start with norepinephrine if patient very hypotensive. Venous thromboembolism reflexes, initiating factor, treatment like hypertension, acute coronary syndrome, pulmonary embolism, chronic heart failure. Non-pharmacological, diet, ventilation, circulatory support. It's very important you advise patient to not eat minus salt. ultrafiltration unload and rapid with ultrafiltration has a benefit. Caris against its trial name trial Caris against ultrafiltration. Treatment of initiating factor like acute coronary syndrome, AF, severe aortic stenosis, RVF, cardiorenal syndrome, peripartum cardiomyopathies, myocarditis, biopsy, diagnosed mainly by biopsy, treatment steroid, immunosuppressive, aspirin, IVIG, plasmapheresis, interferon, autologous blood radiation. It's like some blood go out to be radiated by above ultraviolet, then it's extracorporeally radiated, then return on inside your body. So some new strategies like laser without need for extracorporeal. You know, laser probe connected with cannula from peripheral big vein and they start the radiation without need for blood to be withdrawn outside the body. Monitoring, fluid balance, oxygen saturation, electrolytes. You can make intra-arterial line monitoring pulmonary artery catheter. In future, have left atrial and pulmonary artery pressure sensors, wireless CRTD monitoring telemetry. Future therapies: natriuretic peptide vasodilator diuretics, vasopressin, and vasopressin inhibitor, and adenosine receptor inhibitor. Vasopressin inhibitor and A1 adenosine receptor inhibitor, all this diuretic. Insulin receptor inhibitor, vasodilator, cyclic guanylate cyclase activator, vasodilator, relaxin vasodilator, direct renin inhibitor. Levosimendan inotrope, istaroxime inotrope, direct myosin activator inotrope, stresscobine, corticotropin-releasing hormone receptor stimulator inotropes. Nizritide synthetic BNB, olaritide synthetic NB. Evidence versus placebo has to versus placebo ascend heart failure trial safe. Fusion 2 no benefit. Versus nitroglycerin VMAC trial no mortality but decreased pulmonary capillary wedge pressure. Nizritide has two trials, ascend versus placebo and VMAC versus nitroglycerin. Olaritide synthetic NB evidence serious improve symptom no mortality. Olaritide trial serious. Chimeric synthetic C and D diuretics and it's synthetic C only dilator venodilator work in beta B receptor. Only venodilator work in B receptor. Omabitrelate and Candoxa, Candexitrelate, nebrilizing inhibitor like neuroendopeptidase inhibitor. It's all the forms for nebrilizing inhibitor, but perhaps it cause many side effects like angioedema. Vasopressin inhibitor, non-selective quinaviptan, V1 blood vessel, and selective V2 mainly in collecting tubule, aquaretic. Water deris, tolvaptan, select. Evidence Everest trial, no mortality benefit. Adenosine receptor, A1 inhibitor, rolofillin, adenosine, cardiac adenosine, make cardiac suppression, decrease heart rate. So if I would give adenosine antagonist, it will be beneficial for the patient. Evidence protect, no benefit. Vasodilator insulin receptor inhibitor, insulin antagonist, you know, Bosentan, you know, this medication from pharma, toxicentan, has no role as vasodilator. Guanylate cyclase activator, sinasegwate, no role, stimulate guanylate cyclase, increase cyclic GMBB, increase nitric oxide vasodilator. You know, increase nitric oxide via cyclic GMEB, that's why. Relaxin, synthetic pregnancy hormone, serelaxin, evidence relax, from its name, relaxin, relax AF, 1100 versus placebo. No mortality in first 60 days, but better symptom, early hospital discharge, 37% mortality benefit. After first 2 months, relaxin. Direct renin inhibitor alascarin. Astronaut, atmosphere, no benefit for alascarin direct renin inhibitor. Subgroup analysis, said diabetes, bad, non-diabetic, promising, and non-diabetic patient promising. Levosimendan, 2B, as mirinone. Phosphodiesterase radiation inhibitor, potassium channel opener, calcium channel sensitizer. Calcium channel sensitizer, it's unique mechanism for it. Evidence, all versus dobutamine trial, survive, revive. Better symptom, no mortality. Casino has mortality benefit. Stroxim, sodium potassium ATPase inhibitor, it's enzyme, not receptor. Sodium potassium ATPase inhibitor, it's enzyme, like digoxin. Circa trial, improve relaxation. Horizon AF, no mortality benefit. Horizon heart failure, sorry, no mortality benefit. Stroxim, direct myosin activator. Omecamtiv mecarbil, direct myosin activator. No action on cyclic AMP or calcium. Mechanism direct myosin activator. It's unique mechanism for omecamtiv mecarbil. Omecamtiv mecarbil increased number, duration of cross bridging. Only drug increased ejection systolic time. So it would be more relaxing for the heart. Increased ejection systolic time. Omecamtiv mecarbil. Omecamtiv mecarbil direct myosin activator. Ongoing studies. Alpha 2 receptor antagonist. I only know Yohimbine. It's aphrodisiac, cross-sexual desire, but I don't know has a role for heart failure or no. Alpha 2 receptor antagonist. Gene variant based beta blocker therapy. So every patient has a different genetic pattern. So I would give patient with beta blockers sensitive and is specific for his gene pattern. Every patient has a different genetic pattern. This different genetic pattern make different response for beta blocker therapy. So I won't optimize the response. I would give the patient a beta blocker work specifically for his body genes. Gene therapy, circa vascular and cellular growth factor, sarcoplasmic, endoplasmic reticulum, calcium ATPase, vascular and cellular growth factor, stem cell therapy, incretin dipeptidase 4 inhibitor, glucagon-like peptide 1 agonist, dipeptidase 4 inhibitor, vildagliptin, vildagluz, and the glucagon-like peptide 1 agonist, it's liraglutide, you know, liraglutide, and xenotide group by Tabin. Ion channel modulator, increase sodium and calcium influx, increase contractility. Ion channel modulator. Sodium channel blocker, increase AB duration, axial potential duration. Sodium channel blocker, it would be for cardiac suppression. Antiarrhythmic drug, sodium channel blocker, increase axial potential duration, decrease SA node firing, which would be appropriate for heart failure patient. Iron, it especially for heart failure with anemia. Iron deficiency anemia heart failure. Prostaglandin modulator. Vasodilator, chymase inhibitor, inhibit the renin-angiotensin old serum system. Chymase inhibitor, inhibit renin-angiotensin old serum system. Chymase has a role, like alpha-glutaminase has a role in renin-angiotensin old serum pathway. So inhibitor would inhibit renin-angiotensin old serum system. Neurogalin therapy, inhibit reverse remodeling, increase cardiac function. Growth factor like vascular and cellular growth factor beta. neuroglycerin therapy inhibit reverse remodeling. It's a growth factor too. Neuroglycerin therapy increase cardiac function. Mitochondrial modulator decrease mitochondrial dysfunction. Trimetazidine is a partial fatty acid oxidation inhibitor. We know all this from pharmacy. Ranolazine is a lead sodium channel current inhibitor. It's a second line anti-ischemic. Birixilin, etoximir, inhibits CTB, CBT1, carnitine, palmitol, transferase 1, decrease fatty acid oxidation, carnitine, palmitol, transferase 1, birixilin, and etoximir. Etoximir inhibits CBT1. These drugs, birixilin, etoximir, prohibited, decreased used because of neurotoxicity, nephrotoxicity, hepatotoxicity. Biraxilan, etoximir. Malonyl CoA decarboxylase inhibitor decreases fatty acid uptake, increases glucose metabolism. Malonyl CoA decarboxylase inhibitor decreases fatty acid uptake, increases glucose metabolism. All of this mitochondrial modulator. Malonyl CoA decarboxylase, dichloroacetate inhibit pyruvate dehydrogenase kinase, increase glucose metabolism. All this interfere with fatty acid oxidation pathway, decrease reactive oxygen species, increase glucose metabolism, shift of metabolism for glucose, inhibit fatty acid metabolism. Dichloroacetate inhibit pyruvate dehydrogenase kinase. Elamipretide target mitochondrial electron transport chain, ETC, electron transport chain, increase energy production. Elamipretide has another name, I think, Bendavia. Elamipretide, antifibrotic, pyrifinidone, antifibrotic, decrease collagen synthesis, inhibit myofibroblast, pyrifinidone, HU-1001, drug targeting myofibroblast secretome. Fibrosis synthesis pathway for the heart to go from renin and angiotensin-aldosterone system and myofibroblast secretome, increase collagen synthesis. So I would give modulator to regulate collagen synthesis, decrease fibrosis. Neurotransmitter modulator. I searched Google, not having information about that. Device therapy, supported devices or CRT. Shunt, intra-atrial shunt, intra-atrial shunt, iatrogenic intra-atrial shunt, decompress left atrium or left ventricle, so it would help LV dysfunction or RV dysfunction, valves, especially for valvular heart failure. Autonomic modulator, renal denervation would go up with catheter for renal artery, can denervate it with alcohol, with radiation, with ultrasound, with laser, anyway. Carotid baroreceptor stimulation. Also have a device-based therapy and can make with catheter carotid baroreceptor stimulation, vagal nerve stimulation. It's like an implantable device for carotid baroreceptors. Implantable device go up with two lead for carotid, like continuous carotid massage, decrease sympathetic tone, increase vagal tone, vagal nerve stimulation. Electrical device based therapy. Thank you.